हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑन बेसिक मैथ्स. इन योर लास्ट क्लास वी स्टडीड एलसीएम. वी फाउंड एलसीएम बाय प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन मेथड एंड डिवीजन मेथड. सिमिलरली इन टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाईएस्ट कॉमन फैक्टर, दैट इज एचसीएफ, एंड वी विल डू हाउ टू फाइंड एचसीएफ इन अ वेरी सिंपल वे. HCF can be done by three ways. They are by listing all the factors, by prime factorization, and by division method. Let's do one by one. HCF is the greatest number which divides two or more numbers without a remainder. That is, an integer d is called as the greatest common divisor or highest common factor of two integers a and b, where both of them are not zero. If d divides a and d divides b, and every common divisor of a and b divides d, if these two conditions satisfy, then we will get our HCF. That is, x divides a and x divides b, it implies x divides d. And usually greatest common divisor of a and b is denoted by d is equals to a comma b within a common bracket. So for example, HCF of 8 and 16 is 8 and is denoted by 8 comma 16. Among 8 and 16, 8 is the small number that is greatest divisor of both 8 and 16. 8 divides by 8, 16 divides by 8. Hence, HCF is going to become 8 only. So, we have some rules to find HCF. First rule says by prime factorization method. Express each number as the product of primes. Then, HCF is going to become product of least powers of common factors. I repeat, first we will express each number as the product of primes. Then HCF will be product of least power of common factors. For example, find the HCF of 12, 15, 18. List out the prime factorization of these three numbers. They are 12 is equals to 2 square into 3, 15 is equals to 3 into 5, 18 can be written as 3 square into 2. Now, among these three terms, the common factor is 3. You can check here, 3 is the only number which is common among all the three factors. Hence, the product of least power of common factor is equals to 3. Hence, this is our HCF. Hope you understood this. And I think you will try for the next sum. Similar way how we have done in the previous sum. You just find the prime factorization of 16, 24 and 48. And choose the smallest powers of the common factor. Okay, students. Next rule, rule 2 by division method. Let a and b be any two integers. Without loss of generality, we can assume b is greater than a, greater than 0. On dividing b by a, let q be the quotient and r1 be the remainder. If r1 is equals to 0, then a divides b, thus HCF is equals to a. If r1 is not equals to 0, divide a by r1 and let q2 be the quotient and r2 the remainder. If r2 is equals to 0, then r1 is the HCF of A and B. If R2 is not equals to 0, divide R1 by R2 to get the quotient Q3 and remainder R3. If R3 is equals to 0, then HCF is equals to R2. If R3 is not equals to 0, continue this process of dividing each divisor by the remainder till the remainder becomes 0. The last non-zero remainder is the HCF of A and B. This is known as Euclid's algorithm. We will come to know this method by doing one example. Find the HCF of 55 and 210. So divide 55 and 210, that is 210 by 55. The quotient will be 3, that is 55 into 3 is 165. Then subtract 210 and 165, you get 45. Here 55 is a divisor, 210 is a dividend, 3 is a quotient, 45 is a remainder. Okay, again divide A, that is 55, by 45. We are using the division method rules. Divide 55 by 45, that is 45 ones are 45. Then the remainder will be, R2 will be 10. Take R1, that is 45, and divide it by 10. 10 fours are 40. You get the next remainder, that is R3, that is equals to 5. After subtracting 45 and 40, again take R2, divide it by R3, that is 10 by 5, that is 5 twos are 10. The remainder R4 is equals to 0. The last non-zero remainder is 5. Therefore, 5 is the HCF of 55 and 210. So, in symbols, we will write this as 55, 210 is equals to 5. This is our HCF of 55 and 210. Now, relation between LCM and HCF. If A and B are two numbers, then the product of their LCM and HCF is equals to the product of two numbers. That is, it is given by LCM into HCF, which is equals to the two numbers A into B. To find HCF, we will adjust LCM to the right side, that is, we will divide product by LCM. The same way in case of LCM, that is, to find LCM, we just divide product by HCF. Next one, to find the HCF of fractions, if A upon B, C upon D, E upon F are the proper fractions, then HCF is given by the formula. HCF is equals to HCF of numerators A, C, E upon LCM of denominators B, D, F. Now the sums I am doing from the exercise 1.3. The fourth sum directly, that is, find the greatest integer which divides 42, 52, 86, leaving remainder 6, 4, 2 respectively. So now we are considering the greatest integer, that is, let the number be x. According to the question, x divides 42, leaves the remainder 6. that is 42 minus 6 is equals to 36. And x divides 52 leaves the remainder 4, that is 52 minus 4 is equals to 48. And x divides 86 leaves the remainder 2, that is 86 minus 2 is equals to 84. So now therefore x is the highest common factor of 36, 48 and 84. Find the prime factorization of these three numbers. We get 36 is equals to 2 raised to 2 into 3 raised to 2. 48 is equals to 2 raised to 4 into 3. 84 is equals to 2 raised to 2 into 3 into 7. So x can be written as here the highest common factor is equals to 2 raised to 2 is common among 3 numbers into 3, that is 12, which is the required greatest common divisor. Next sum, find the HCF of 8 by 9, 32 by 81, 16 by 27. So find the HCF of numerator first. Here HCF is going to become 8. How 8? 8 upon 8. 8 divides 8. 32 divides by 8. 16 divides 8. The highest common factor of 8, 32 and 16 will be 8 only. Similarly, least common divisor, multiplier of denominator, that is 9, 81, 27 is going to become 81. Use the LCM method to find HCF. So when you divide these two, you get 8 upon 81. If you keep like this way also, it's okay. If it is divisible, you can divide. Otherwise, keep the HCF as it is. Next sum, if the HCF of two numbers is 42 and their product is 52,920, find their LCM. So write down the given factors in the question. HCF is equals to 42. Product of two numbers A into B is equals to 52,920 and LCM is equals to question mark. So our formula is product of two terms, that is A into B is equals to product of the numbers, their LCM into their HCF, that is H into L. So substitute their values, that is A into B is equals to 52,920, H is 42. L we have to find. So keep L as it is. So now to find L, divide both the sides by 42 and cancel the number 52,920 by 42, you get 1,260. So this is our LCM. Similarly, the next sum, seventh one, the HCF of two numbers is 16 and their LCM is 160. If one of the number is 64, find the other number. So write down the given terms. HCF is given, that is 16. LCM is given, that is 160. A is 64. Find B, other number. So write the formula. Substitute their values. A into B is equals to H into L. To find B, divide H into L by A. That is 16 into 160 divided by 64. After cancellation, you get 40. 16 ones are 16. 16 fours are 64. Again, 4 ones are 4. 4s are 16. 0 as it is. You get the other value, other number, that is B is equals to 40. Now exercise 1.3, they will ask such questions for 3 marks. First one, find the HCF of the following by factorization method. So I hope you will try this sum. Second one, by division method. There are 5 questions in first main and second main. Third one, find the largest integer which divides 105 and 315. So similar sum we have done in this session only. So you can use the method. And fourth one, fifth one, sixth one, seventh one we have done in this class only. So hope you understood and you can copy all these things in the maintained book in your fair way. So with this I will conclude. We will meet to find to know more about the numbers in the next session. Thank you.